My name is Godmin. Thank you for joining us in this video. So in this video, we're going to talk about inquiry-based lesson. And it's my pleasure today to welcome Dr. Yeap Ban Har to answer some questions related to inquiry-based lesson. Dr. Yeap?
Hello.
So inquiry-based lesson is a very big word. So could you help us understand what is meant by inquiry-based learning? And also, how does it relate to the learning experiences that you have always spoken about?
So I've always been talking about learning experiences, including exploration, structured learning, practice, reading and writing, journal writing, and reflection. When I check the internet, for example, one of the sources say that inquiry-based learning is a learning process that engages students by making real-world connections through exploration and high-level questioning. So inquiry-based learning always include, or at least start with, exploration. So that is one of the learning experiences. Another model that I think teachers are quite familiar with for inquiry-based learning is the 5E model for inquiry-based learning. And the 5E include engage. So that's done through the use of a real-world scenario, a real-world problem, or at least something concrete enough for students to be able to make sense of, and then explore. So again, you notice exploration is such a critical part of learning. And then explain, elaborate. I suppose explain is done orally when students are working in groups, and elaboration can be done through the writing, the journaling, and finally evaluating, which is part of reflection. So really, I think the learning experiences are just learning experiences that is part and parcel of inquiry-based learning anyway. They are not so different, isn't it?
Yes, that's right. So today we're going to zoom in into a particular concept, and it's a concept that many students find difficulty with, which is the trigonometric identity of sine squared x plus cosine squared x equals to 1. So some students find it very abstract. And how would you think that inquiry-based learning can come in this aspect to help students overcome that abstractness that they find?
So if I were the teacher, I would go to class and tell my students, class, today we have a problem, and our problem is to investigate. We are going to investigate the square of the sine of an angle and the square of cosine of an angle. And I will let students go ahead with calculators in their hand, pick the values they like, and begin to investigate what happens when they put in different values into the terms. And I'm sure at some point, they are going to realize that regardless of the angles they have chosen, the sum of those two terms always add up to a constant, one in particular. So as a teacher, I would do that. I would go to class and present it very simply, rather open, and let's see what the students do. And afterwards, we can organize their thoughts, share their ideas in a more structured fashion. That's how I would start.
So in this aspect that you have shared, I think it involves a lot of facilitation. So what are some key aspects of facilitation that you would see would be helpful for teachers when they are carrying such an investigation task?
So as a teacher, I think we very often are guided by the six learning experiences. So when I'm doing the exploration, my questioning is more open. It's like, here's a problem, go, find out, work with your friends. And then we observe what they do. And during the structured discussion, I will capitalize on what I assess. If you're not so good in, for example, organizing the data, then during the writing on the whiteboard, I will model a good way of organizing whatever they have gotten, you know, to facilitate the seeing of the pattern that emerged from that. So I think the questioning the teachers use are very often guided by the learning experiences. So during structured learning, the teachers would ask questions including, oh, is there anything that's interesting? Rather open. And at some point, something more converging. For example, I wonder how we can spot the observation that some of the groups have made. So I would imagine some of the questioning will be more open and others will be more closed.
So regarding the topic of the students, So some teachers may be thinking that this kind of inquiry-based learning structure is more suited for the students who are stronger or students who are more outspoken. So what's your take on this?
Actually, on the contrary, I think that this kind of learning is suitable for every student. For the advanced learners, they really need that kind of challenge. After all, you know, learning content is not difficult, but investigating, dealing with something more open could be a challenge for them. Or even working with friends, collaborating could be something difficult for them. But for the struggling learners, some teachers will say, well, maybe they cannot do investigation. But on the contrary, all learning theories say that they are the ones who need this. You see, why are they not doing well in mathematics? What has happened up to this point? Up to this point, they have been exposed to very structured lesson. So I suspect it's a structured lesson that has messed them up. And according to learning theories, that is not surprising. Learning theories like that of Piaget says that these students need time, need processing time, and investigation. Give them that free time, free space. In a structured lesson of the teacher explaining, they have very little time. They are catching up with what the teachers are trying to explain. So in a more structured lesson, teacher giving a lecture or explanation, the processing time is actually quite little. But in a investigation lesson, they have more time to process whatever they do. Also, these students have not been doing well because of the structuredness. And that is supported by the learning theory by Deans. Deans say that we learn initially by exploring. And when we begin with structured learning at first, we often alienate quite a big group of students. The human nature is such, when we first learn something, it has to be messy, unstructured. Just like the way we learn things when we are young. Like, you know, when a parent want them to know that animal is a cat, I'm sure no parent in the right mind will prepare PowerPoint to teach the child that that animal is a cat, right? We learned it in a rather playful, unstructured, incidental way. And contrary to popular belief, the weaker students would actually benefit more from such lessons. And I've given you simply two justification: processing time by Piaget and exploration by Deans. But I can tell you, every single learning theory will provide justification why this lesson is necessary for the struggling learners. So actually, on the contrary, it is the struggling learners who need this more than the advanced learners. Advanced learners, I think whatever lessons you do with them, they will still learn. I suspect even without a teacher, just watching videos, they will also learn. I mean, the content.
Of course, for teachers, there's always the concern of time. So with investigative tasks, naturally you will take up more time at the start. So some teachers feel that they will not have enough time to cover the curriculum and affect the other aspects of the curriculum time. So what's your take on this?
Teaching through investigation helps students learn the content. But on top of that, they also learn how to learn. The more traditional approach, lecture or explaining, that will teach students the content, but very often does not teach students how to learn. So although investigative type of lessons seems to take more time in the beginning, because students are also concurrently learning how to learn, the subsequent stages of learning, later part of the year, they will learn faster. And actually, it does not take more time. It takes less time. In a traditional approach, the concepts in a later part of the curriculum, it's more challenging. And when students have not learned how to learn, they will actually struggle and they will take longer time when it comes to those topics. So I think investigative lessons, although it seems like it takes a lot of time, I suspect it happens more in the beginning when we are setting the routines, teaching them how to work in groups, teaching them this and that about investigation. But once the lessons are in progress, they are going to learn how to learn, and that's the thing that will make them learn faster towards the end of the school year.
One last question on investigation tasks. So are there some topics that are more suitable for such investigative tasks than the others in mathematics?
I think the answer is yes, but not so much in terms of topic. Scams theory is about the kind of understanding students learn in mathematics. So scams theory tell us that there are three types of understanding in mathematics. One is what you and I would call conceptual understanding, knowing meaning. But I believe Scams in his book refer to that as relational understanding. But let's just say conceptual understanding. The second one is procedural understanding. I think in his book, he talked about instrumental understanding. Again, I'll just say procedural understanding. And the third one is conventional understanding, which is understanding the conventions we use in mathematical language. So in mathematics, we have all kinds of convention. For example, for integration, we adopt, I believe, is Leibniz convention. We do not use Newton's convention, I think so. But anyway, we all know that in mathematics, we do have certain convention. The symbols and notations are all convention. Order of operation, that's a convention. It's like, it's just the way people have been doing this. It's almost like the grammar of mathematics. Yeah, like when we got a bunch of combined operations, we always do the parentheses or the bracket first, then later the power, the exponent. Yeah, so that's a convention. Now, coming back to your question, are there certain things that are best taught through investigation? I think convention, what do? You just tell students, this is the way, you just show them, this is the way we write differentiation, this is the way we write integrals. So conventions, there's nothing to investigate really. You just read up, or someone just tell you. So I think other than conventions, every aspect of mathematics lend itself to investigation. Through investigation, we learn the concepts that go hand in hand with the procedures. For example, say the topic of sum of interior angles in a polygon. I can imagine the teacher giving students a bunch of cutouts and asking them to investigate the sum of the angles in the hexagon or the pentagon. And they do whatever they do, including cutting the polygons up into triangles and making use of a prior knowledge that for triangles, the interior angles add up to 180 degrees.